apropos of nothing, you just got a taste of what happens every time I wear this dang thing. That I'm constantly looking in mirrors trying to see if it's straight on straight. And it never is. Today is a wonderful day in many ways. But I'll tell you about that in a second. Let's jump into the verse for this week, y'all. Read along if you got something to read along on. And if you're on the internet, then you do. 2 Corinthians 5:16. Therefore, from now on, we regard no one according to the flesh. Even though we have known Christ according to the flesh, yet now we know him thus no longer. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. Now all things are of God, who has reconciled us to himself through Jesus Christ, and has given us the ministry of reconciliation. That is, that God was in Christ reconciling the world to himself, not imputing their trespasses to them, and has committed to us the word of reconciliation. Now then, we are ambassadors for Christ. As though God were pleading through us, we implore you, on God's behalf, Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. For he made him who knew no sin to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in him. That is still the most amazing promise, I think, in the Bible. That is out of this world. Now, it's made multiple times, so I'm totally hedging my bets by saying the most amazing. But that's amazing. I mean, a lot of times, okay, and you'll be called a child of God, salvation, hey, get to go to heaven, I'll transform your life, blah, 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 all these awesome things. But the righteousness of God. I mean, where else do we get... I'm going to sneeze. Where else do we get a promise of, like, being part and parcel to the power and pure power of God? I mean, that's out of control. That's an awesome promise. That is an enormous responsibility to be that dang righteous, isn't it? It was funny, when I was reading this, I kind of thought about it for the first time. Regarding no one according to the flesh. To me, that's actually a cool, interesting, and new way to look at lusting. Because indeed, anytime we lust after a person, we are typically, at least 70% of the time, and even 70% of the experience, 80% of the experience, we are lusting after that person's flesh, after an aesthetic principle, an aesthetic slash pheromonal a principle that appeals to us. And I often have trouble with the whole lust thing, just on a purely objectification sort of framework, where I feel like people are more than that, and are meant to be more than that always. I mean, obviously, people are meant to be called to be children of God, to build themselves on the righteousness of God, to seize the righteousness of God. Holy cow. And so, it's actually another framework in that we objectify everybody. We're not supposed to judge anyone according to the flesh. It's very interesting. So really, like, almost any time you're noticing someone's well-tailored high thread count. Do they even do thread counts on suits? I don't know why I said that. But their high thread count suit and their full shopping bags or whatever. Where it's so easy for us to get caught up in a number of layers of sin there. Covetousness, envy. Who knows? You could murder them in their heart. You could be so jealous. But to remember daily, minute by minute, that we are to judge no one according to the flesh. That's fantastic. That's amazing. But this is also a huge burden responsibility, too, because it's like we are to see no one according to the flesh. If you are reborn in Christ, you are a brand new thing. And we are to extol those people, as Christians, you're supposed to extol those people, lift people up. And then to people who are not in Christ, you're supposed to do the same thing. Extol them, lift them up, see them not as they are here with your eyes, but see them how they are in their souls, which is amazing. We don't have, like, magic powers all the time. Sometimes. I've seen it happen. It's pretty cool. But most of the time, we're just being other human beings, and we're trying to just merely see them for who they are, which is tragic and flawed and sinful beings like we are, in need of monstrous love. And since this is National Listening Day, .org. The day has a .org?
NationalListeningDay.org.
Well, that sounds suspicious to me.
No, it's good.
It's a nice idea. Since today's National Listening Day,
.org.
I think that's actually one of the best ways one can try to commune with somebody that is not of the flesh. Is listening, listening, listening. Listen with your eyes. No, not in a salty way. But body language is speaking. Listen today. How about, let's try that, y'all. I'm going to try it today. I'm going to my Uncle Dan's wedding today. Woohoo! So I'm going to be with family, some of which are very easy to get along with, some of which are trickier. I'm going to be with a ton of strangers. But I'm excited. And why don't y'all join me today on seeking to see past the veil of this world, which is just a veil, bridal veil. Let's go ahead and lift that. Let's kiss the bride of Christ. Or where the bride of the church is, whatever. I'm mixing my metaphors. And let's listen the crap out of people today. And no matter what you see with your eyes will deceive you. Your ears will deceive you sometimes, too. I just thought I heard someone yell no about 10 minutes ago. And I was like, oh, Pa, why did you scream no? She was like, I didn't. So either she's a liar or I didn't hear anything, so my ears deceived me. But let your ears not deceive you. Let's listen. Let's listen and listen deeply. Speak and speak deeply. Remember, we are emissaries of Christ given the word of reconciliation. So first and foremost, let us listen to God. Second of all, let us listen to others. And then third of all, go ahead and pay attention to yourself a little bit today too. All right? How about that? But third, you're third place. You're a bronze medalist. Be happy with it. Some people don't medal at all. Except those meddlesome meddlers. Amen. Selah.